Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to make bright orange flares from simple ingredients. Orange flares are beautiful and very simple to make. Over the past month, I've been experimenting with various different ratios and chemicals to find the most reliable composition. To start this project, you'll need the following: potassium nitrate, KNO₃, sugar, sodium carbonate or sodium bicarbonate, magnesium powder, and I recommend using 200 micrometer particle size. You'll also need a scale, a funnel, some sort of tube to hold the composition, Visco Fuse, and a container to mix the components in. Additionally, you can use colored craft paper for decoration, but that's up to you. Through my testing, I found that these two work remarkably well. They both burn very similar, despite having a slight difference in the composition. Also, one thing to mention is that you can replace the sugar with charcoal. From what I saw, it did improve the burn. In this video, I'll be using the recipe that consists of 43% magnesium, 29% sodium carbonate, and 16% KNO₃, and lastly 12% sugar. But feel free to try the other composition. First up, you need to weigh out each chemical. For the purpose of this video, I am only making 1 gram in total, but you can make however much you want to. Okay, maybe not this much, but you get the point. I observed that 1 gram roughly burned for 11 seconds if packed in a 5mm tube. The burn rate will increase if the tube is wider and thus decrease when it's smaller in diameter. When measuring, don't look at the very last decimal, as it doesn't need to be perfect. Now when you're done weighing everything, grab your desired mixing container. I prefer paper cups over plastic cups because it is a bit safer. As you may have noticed, my nitrate is quite clumpy. So to get around this, get a strainer and sift the chunks through so that it becomes a fine powder. To speed this up, you can add some marbles to crush it for you. Close the top off your container and shake it vigorously for a few minutes, or use the diaper method. This mixture isn't sensitive like flash powder. But don't be fooled, this isn't safe at all. Nitrates will attack uncoated magnesium and may cause an unexpected explosion. So to be extra safe, coat your magnesium. And that right there is how to make an orange flare composition. Simple, right? Now let's see exactly how much I got. Sure enough, still 1 gram. This powder would burn in itself, but to make it easier for use, you can pack it in a tube. This is done by either taping one end of the tube or plugging it using clay or hot glue. Use what you have laying around, it is not important. Now that you have made a plug, place a funnel in the tube and add the powder. A gentle tap on the side will help it get through. At this point, you want to compress it. This ensures maximum burn time and it makes it better suited for storage. This mixture can be lit using a lighter, but for added safety, we'll be adding a fuse to the top, thus giving us some time to back off. Now cut a 4-6cm Visco fuse and bend one end of it so it matches a V shape, and insert it into the tube like this. It's basically done now and ready for use. Be creative and you can create all kinds of housings for these flares. This is just an example of one I made earlier. So now guys, let's go test the flare that I just made. This has been Pyrotronics, subscribing is free, and like or dislike, it's all up to you. I'll see you next time. The video is over, so you don't need to technically keep watching, but let me show you some clips from my many orange flare experiments.
up.
Yeah, these fuses suck, man.